Hi, I'm Dorcas. In this video, I am going to show you how I use a mural template to introduce students to mural and also to introduce them to the module that I'm teaching. If you want a link to the mural, it's going to be in the comments of this video. So let's show you. So here we are in the template, and of course I'm going to zoom in for you to see different things. So this is the template. As I said, if you want to use this template, it will be in the links in the video, in the description below the video. If you ever do use the template, please let me know, because I'm also I'm new to this, I'm not so new to mural, but I'm only new to this idea that we have here since like about 2 weeks maybe, or a few weeks I should say. So I'm sure there's better ways to do it, so if you know of a better way, please let me know. However, this is what I've done. So I'm just going to zoom into this part first because I've already used this before. So you can see here, this is in four different quadrants. So the module that I was teaching was related to creativity. So you can see here, if I zoom in, the questions are related to creativity. So the idea is that the students would make a post-it about each of these different questions. So it's like, to start them thinking along certain lines, or if you want them to do some pre-course work, they could maybe share the results there. And the idea is that it's going to be like, so I had 36 people in this class, it's going to be full of like loads of different post-its from different people. And by the way, when I say I had in the class, it's me and my facilitator. Usually when I work with the Innovation Academy, there's two of us facilitating. So I shouldn't be saying I should be saying we. So that's that quadrant. Now, that bit is kind of easy enough to use. For the students, they simply double click and add a post-it. That's that. However, I made this a bit more fancy or a bit more complicated for the students. So you can see there's an introduction over in the right hand side, which is really basic, and you could add more to that if you wanted to. I've decided to keep the instructions kind of at the top. So you can see here I just have this welcome. So there's sort of two purposes to this mural. The first purpose is so that they will, like they being the students will be introduced to mural, and they'll have to do certain things here on the mural board that will mean that when they're using it in class, there'll be less kind of messing around figuring out how to use it, because they'll be like pretty good at using mural by the time they're finished this task. And then the second thing is also to introduce them to the Innovation Academy. So the Innovation Academy is in UCD, and we do things a little bit different there, as in it's not very traditional lecture kind of style. And this particular module was called Creativity and Innovation, or Creative Thinking and Innovation. So you can see here there's a little bit of text about the experiential learning by doing here of the Innovation UCD Innovation Academy. Then over here there's instructions about how to use this board. So this video is not about how to use the board, it's aimed at the facilitator so that you can edit any of these things. So if you use this template, for example, if you want to edit any of these things, you're going to get the template, then you click edit template. Now, I'm warning you as well before you edit the template that this template that I'm using here took an awful lot of time. So if you do tweak things, I suggest that you tweak the minimum amount of things possible. Otherwise, for example, changing one of the things in the rows, and I know I haven't really showed you these rows yet, but if you want to change one task here for the students, it's an awful lot of work for you to do. It's not like a 5 minute job. So ideally you don't tweak this, or you tweak it as little as possible. So you can see here are the instructions. So on the left hand side of the board, find your row. So the way this works is the first two rows are for the facilitators, and then I have all these other rows. So each student has a row. You can see that each row there, I've called it Joseph Blogs or Josephine Blogs, and then this nickname, it says there, call me Joe. They're going to change that with their own names, and I just have them numbered. So I have them numbered all the way down to 38, because usually we might have around that or as a maximum in our classes in the Innovation Academy. Usually 36, but sometimes you might have one or two more. So I've numbered them because what happens with this is I send out an invitation, or a welcome email, I should say, to the students who have signed up to the module, with the Zoom link. and the timing that we're going to be online and so on, and also a link to this mural and some vague instructions because I want them to figure this out themselves. But in the email as well, they'll get a number, they'll see their name assigned to a number. So for example, so-and-so will be number 36, you'll be number 35, and so on. So they'll find their line or their row, and then they'll modify this row and they'll fill it all in. Up the top, I'm just going to scroll up because up the top, I've already mine filled out. And ideally, you as a facilitator will have yours filled out at the start so that the students can see how it's done, what's expected. So this is the current reel thing that I'm using. You can see the first row there, I've changed the Joe blogs to my name and call me Dorcas. So call me Dorcas, that says there. And let's just zoom in. So you can see on the top row, this is the row that I've edited for myself, and the row underneath is not edited yet. So you can see the first thing there, it says add an image of your object. We're asking our students to bring along an object to introduce themselves with. So I'm going to be introducing myself with my camera. Second thing, this says add a blue sticky with the title of your course, for example BE Electrical Engineering, which is actually what I did, but I changed my blue sticky notes to UCD Innovation Academy Facilitator. Next one, it says remove the sticky notes, so I've done that there. Change this type of sticky from a circle to a square, so now you can see the students are getting familiar with not just like adding a sticky note, deleting a sticky note, but also changing a sticky note. Next thing is still related to sticky notes. Change the sticky note into a different or any different color. And as you know, in mural, it's useful to be able to know that or to ask students how to do that. Add a picture that represents you. So now you can see they're introducing themselves to each other here, and also they're learning how to add in a picture of themselves. Add a pink line in this box, so you can see they've done that, or I've done that even there. And then this is one just where I wanted them to use the drawing tool. So I just made this paint by numbers, so you can see that's what it looks like originally with the numbers. And it's not so simple, but it's not so complicated either. The idea is that it's supposed to be it's supposed to be like a bulb with like a leaves or a shrub inside it, so it's kind of about creativity and ideation and growing and so on. Then the next thing here, so this is optional, so if they want they can add in a link to something. So I didn't want to force them to add in a link to their social media if they didn't want to, but it's just the practices that they can learn how to add a link. Second thing is about unlocking. And this is, if you want your students to use this, and I did, you have to invite them as members. So they can't, a guest cannot do this in Mural. You can only do this as a member. So that's a handy thing that I found people sort of need to be able to do when they're doing like a design sprint and they're doing, empathy boards and things like that. You need to be able to lock the backgrounds. So that's where I've asked the students to join as members, and also that's a good thing because by the time they're in your class next week, they're not going to have to be, you know, signing into Mural or like kind of getting stressed about that. They can do it in their own time the week previously, so they have to like unlock that and then of course move it over. So that's what I've done there. Then I just say here, zoom in to read instructions. Now I know probably they've already done it to draw, you know, on this, but and obviously they will have done it to find their row, but I just added that in, zoom in to read instructions, just so that they can see this is the maximum they can zoom in. And this is where they're going to add icons. So that's using the Zoom or the Mural icons, not Zoom. Then the next thing there is add a GIF that represents what you want from this module. And again, this is a GIF that I've added from Mural itself. And then the last thing is just to edit the text. So now they know how to edit the text. And then finally, they get to the end. At my end, I'm done, there's no arrows. But here you can see it says, great, now do part two. And that's where they go over and do this creativity thing. And I'm just going to zoom out a little bit because this is live, but I don't want to show you any personal instructions. By the way, I added this in because in this particular example, I did not email the students their name and number. So they had to find it on the side here. But you can see here, the really nice thing with the pink thing here is I can see here how many students have completed and how many have not. So for example, I can see that these students here have not completed this task at all. So whereas the students here, they have at least started or began. So I just found that in particular quite easy. So that, you know, maybe if I just also go back to the template. So you can see here in the template, right? So as you can imagine, I made the row and then copied and copied and copied and copied all the way down. However, then it was really kind of monkey work, sort of labor intensive, because you can see certain things here are locked and certain things aren't. So for example, if I go into, let's say, this row, you can see here I'm clicking and trying to move, and you can see there the little lock icon, like it's showing me that that's locked, I can't move it. Sometimes the lock icon appears. So anyway, I can't move this. So if I want to be able to modify this, I right click and then unlock it and so on. So there's certain things that you want to be locked. So for example, this arrow, I want that to be locked. Whereas this sticky note, I don't want this to be locked because I want them to be able to remove this. So the really annoying part with making this template was that because you want to be able to copy and paste each row, and by the way, if you know of a better way to do it, please let me know in the comments below this video, or let me know anyway, because I found it really labor intensive, because I had to make each row unlocked. So in order to copy the row, it has to be unlocked, at least that's what I found, and then I had to go back and lock things you know, individually. So everything, single thing in each row here is locked, like one by one, or unlocked one by one, whatever. And also, if you're making a template like this, as in maybe you don't want to use the my template but you want to make your own, if you are making it, make sure you get like the front and back kind of clear. I know this is kind of obvious, but let's just say, for example, you can see here that this is actually posted, that, or a sticky, whatever you want to call it, in a circle, which is like in their row. So that means the row is at the back, and then the circle is you know, in front of that, and then this is in front of that. So visually, you can see how this is a transparent circle. It would have looked pretty much the same if this had been behind the circle, because, you know, there's nothing, the circle isn't filled in, but then the students wouldn't have been able to modify that. So that's just another thing to be careful with if you are using this template or using another template for yourselves. So I think that's it. This video is really, it's for anyone, but it's especially for people who are working with the Innovation Academy of UCD. So hopefully it will be useful for you guys. And if you have any questions or comments, you know how to get me. And if you don't know, just check the description below this video. Bye. I also just want to add one more thing. Thank you to Martin Feely, because he was the person who helped me with the idea for this whole mural board in the first place. So thanks, Martin.